అమరావతిలో స్టార్టప్ ఏరియా ఫేజ్ వన్ దగ్గర వెల్కమ్ గ్యాలరీకి శంకుస్థాపన అనంతరం సీఎం చంద్రబాబు మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు లైవ్ చూద్దాం.
Now things are happening towards that. I really appreciate Minister, Honorable Minister, and also the Government of Singapore for extending all the cooperation for the last 5 years, even preparing master plan details from then onwards on so many activities. At that time we don't have an idea how to build a capital. Then I request the Government of Singapore, can you assist me and give master plan details? If I go for competitive route, it will take so much of time. Even Singapore government may not interest in that. As a good gesture, immediately they responded. Without taking any money, they took to the central cabinet, national cabinet, and then finally they have given me master plan details in 3 installments. One is seed capital, capital city, capital region. From then onwards, it has become a reality. I really appreciate farmers here. They are all here. Nowhere in a democratic country in the world, voluntarily they have given me 33,000 acres of land. This is the biggest contribution from the farmers. For this contribution, even farmers are getting benefit. It is a win-win situation. At that time, I don't have money. I want to acquire. It will take so much of time. And also, even somebody will go for litigation, then it will be an unending process. Thanks to them, now we are going in a fast track. You are seeing today, trunk infrastructure we are building in a big way. We are spending nearly 40,000 crores on trunk infrastructure, and also some more money we are going to spend. Even land pooling infrastructure we are building in a big way. This is where seed area, Singapore government and also Andhra Pradesh government, we are working together. Amaravati Development Company, we are very happy today it is taking shape. I am assuring the minister and also representative from Singapore, they helped me in so many areas, not one or two areas, even skill development, even other areas like administration, even Lee Kuan Yew Institute of Public Policy. Recently, they studied ease of doing business. They rated earlier 5th place. Today they have rated Andhra Pradesh is number 1. We are very happy. We are thankful to them. Even this way, Singapore is a great inspiration for us. And also they are giving so much of assistance for us on technology wise and also best practices. Even my civil servants, they have trained in a big way in Singapore, in Lee Kuan Yew Institute. After training, our people are totally confident, and also they have been exposed outside with all public policies and also on governance. Now it is a very wonderful time. So many things we have started here. Administrative capital is going on in a fast track. Trunk infrastructure is going in a big way. Even land pooling infrastructure we have developed. Earlier it is only an idea. Now by seeing all these things, it is a reality. We are having an advantage of building a new capital. Always to build a capital, it is a very difficult process. It is a very painful process also. We don't have any resources. And at the same time, to build a capital, it is a rare opportunity. That crisis we want to convert into an opportunity, and at the same time we wanted to build one of the best capital in the world. It will be ranked 1 among top 5 in the world. That is our vision, that is our commitment. I am confident we will achieve it with the support of Singapore government and also persons like Iswaran ji, always is supportive. Today this is one demonstrative center. anybody wanted to have any experience with the latest technologies or best practices, they can come here. Under the same time, anybody wanted to demonstrate or project any latest technologies, they can place here. This is going to become one of the most attractive place and also most experienced center. Once there is a proper experience, then naturally we are going to implement it. Always I am saying, we are in an inspiring time. IoT, technology, and also if you see anything you want to do, you can do real time. Even our e-pragati and also RTG real-time governance, we are able to coordinate with all latest technologies as on today. Even earlier, one example I will give you, we conducted 4 years back Janmabhoomi. We got nearly 1.5 crore applications, grievances, 15 million. Then it is very difficult for us to handle all these things. Today, continuously 6 times we have conducted. Now all grievances were reduced into very small size, around 4.4 million. Even all 0.4 million, by using technology, we are able to sort it out in real time. Janmabhoomi is for a period of 10 days. Within 10 days, we are able to sort it out. Tomorrow I am going to place before public progress report of Janmabhoomi. This is the grievances, this is the type of grievances, these are all the grievances we are able to redress. That is a very interesting time we are all living. Yesterday, Adani group came to me. We had a wonderful MOU. They are going to establish world the best data center in Visakhapatnam by spending nearly 40,000 crores. And they are going to spend another 30,000 crores on green energy, renewable energy, that is solar energy. So very cost-effective energy for the data center. And you know very well, future, how much money you are having is not the question, how much data is you are having. You are a big data owner, then we can do wonders. You will earn money that will be measured as wealth in future. So we are moving a different world. As on today, if you see, ease of doing business, we are number one. Continuously, we are number one in India. We wanted to be at four, top five in the world. Second one, we are going ease of living. In this also, we are going to provide one smartphone for every family. By having smartphone, no need to come to anywhere, any office, any work, you will get it done through smartphone. Now we are moving corrupt-free society. We want to motivate people. Ultimately, most livable standards we want to establish. I can measure air quality, water quality, food quality. We are going now natural farming. No fertilizer, no pesticide. You can imagine all these things are possible because of technology and knowledge. So what I am saying, if you use technology and protect nature, we can do wonders. That is the best way of living. With the support of Singapore, with this experience center, we are going to get best practices, best technologies and best knowledge available all over the world for the benefit of our community. And we'll showcase in such a way others can emulate, others can follow. That day is not far away. I am very happy. This place is a wonderful place. Where you are sitting, next to this excellent river. Nowhere in the world this type of river, that too fresh water. Every year this river is irrigating nearly around 2 to 3 million acres of land. It is a perennial. Now we are linking rivers. Godavari water is coming to Krishna. From here it is going to reach Penna. all 5-6 rivers across the state, we want to link it so that all rivers will become perennial rivers. So water is energy, that it is big energy for anybody to see water. That type of water is available. With the support of our people like you, we wanted to build one of the most beautiful place to live in. Everybody should be very happy and proud to associate with this project. With this, I am thanking all of you. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir, for those words of support and encouragement. I would now like to request Sri S. Iswaran, Minister of Communication and Information and Minister in Charge of Trade Relations, Republic of Singapore, to please share a few words.
Your Excellency, Chief Minister Sri Chandrababu Naidu, ministers, many familiar faces from the government of Andhra Pradesh as well as from the business delegation and government organizations in Singapore. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon. First of all, I have to say that this event is about 2 hours later than it should have been. That's because of the fog that descended on several airports and delayed a lot of our travel. So I want to apologize for keeping all of you waiting. But I think this is an event that is indeed a very special one and a milestone in the evolution of the relationship between Andhra Pradesh and Singapore, and also specifically with respect to the development of Amaravati. We have a strong and growing relationship between the government of Andhra Pradesh, led by Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu, and Singapore, led by our Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong. We have found different ways to cooperate, focused on the development of the capital city through the master planning and right through now to the first steps in the development of the catalytic part of the seed area. And I think this is an important first step in the next phase of the work that we do between the two countries, between Singapore and Andhra. I want to also say that this has been made possible because of the strong support and vision of Sri Chandrababu Naidu and the support of his ministers and members of the cabinet and also the officials in the Andhra Pradesh government who, if I know, had to work very creatively in different ways in order to accomplish many of the tall orders that have been placed before them. And I also want to make put on record a special thanks to the farmers who have participated in the land pooling exercise and given the government and Mr. Chandrababu Naidu the support so that this project can take off. And I'm glad that many of the farmers are here today to join us for this event. And thank you very much for joining us. Thank you. I think this event and this welcome gallery is significant for at least a couple of reasons. One, because it helps to bring attention to the capital city, international attention to the capital city, because we want to be able to showcase what is happening here, the initiatives that are being taken by the government, and the specific developments that are already taking place in terms of infrastructure, and the opportunities that are available to investors and other interested developers who want to come in. So I think from the point of view of getting a very quick vantage into the state of Andhra Pradesh and in particular the Amaravathi and capital city area, I think this is going to be a very important facility. The other significant thing about this welcome gallery is the fact that we have a truly multinational participation in it. We've seen companies not just from Singapore, but also from Japan and others who are bringing in technology from, say, Germany. And the intent is really to bring in as diverse a range of enterprises from different countries to this welcome gallery, because we want that breadth of involvement in the development of this capital city. That's what is going to ensure that we get the best standards, the best quality, and therefore the people of Andhra Pradesh will then get the best possible capital city as envisioned by the Chief Minister. So I'm very glad that many of the companies are already here, and I'm quite sure that this is only the beginning and many more will come as they see the opportunities and the developments take place. And finally, I'm also very glad that we have our Singapore business delegation here who have had a meeting with their Andhra Pradesh counterparts as part of the business council between Andhra Pradesh and Singapore. And I think that is again another important foundation towards the growing relationship between our two countries. So I want to conclude by once again thanking all of you for being here today, and also to thank the Chief Minister, his colleagues, and the officials of Andhra Pradesh government for your strong support for this project, and finally to wish all of you a very happy, healthy, and prosperous New Year. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your words of encouragement. We at ADP envision the Welcome Gallery to be a destination to foster many fruitful relationships and partnerships. With a view to materialize this vision, we've initiated a partnership program and requested to bring together a lot of market leaders, startups, and academic influencers to contribute in four key areas of collaboration. We've received an overwhelming response in 15 companies and institutions from countries including Germany, Japan, Singapore, and India have expressed their interest and have executed the memoranda of understanding. I would now like to request Ms. Nina Yang, Chairperson and Director of Amaravati Development Partners, and Srimati Lakshmi Parthasarathy, Chairperson and Managing Director, Amaravati Development Corporation, to please join us on the stage for the exchange of MOUs. I would now like to request the Institute of South Asian Studies, an autonomous research institution at the National University of Singapore, which is dedicated to research on the contemporary South Asia, to please come onto the stage for the exchange of the MOU. Asahi Glass, a Japanese global glass manufacturing company headquartered in Tokyo. Innovative startup company from Singapore involved in image analytics with a primary focus on geospatial data. An advanced materials company that aims